Thank you very much. Yeah. And I thank Lambert, Gary, everybody who gave me this opportunity. A lot of you people, I mean, I wanna first echo what Judge Gray said. This is history in the making right now. All of you people here are here for one reason or another to help us change history. You're here because you care about this history that we're changing. You know, Bill said it completely right. Every single one of us can make a huge difference. And I always, you know, call out the people who show up as superheroes, because that's all it takes. All you have to do is show up to be part of this, and you can make a difference. I was a collective operator for a while, and I got to see some of these things that the good doctor and Bill were talking about. I got to see, as I was providing medicine for sick people, I got to talk to them, and I got to hear their stories, and I got to, you know, see what made that one person who didn't look so sick, what made them tick, and you got to see these effects over time. You spend time with them every time they come back and they tell you a story. And that's one of the most powerful stories I always remember hearing was from the patients that were relieving themselves from heavy narcotics. And they come back and they have more color in their face and they smile a little more and their eyes would be clearer. I'm not a doctor, I have no medical training. But I've studied herbal medicine for 30 years and I've watched people and I've participated in trying to help people. And that's all. I'm an observer and a facilitator. But you learn a lot that way, and you watch the reality of this. And, you know, I'm always talking to people about the truth. And what we're dealing with is a truth. And there's some good parts of that truth and some really bad parts of that truth. And I've experienced a little bit of both. And we talked about negative side effects of cannabis. I want to talk about a negative side effect of cannabis. 500,000 people a year are imprisoned in America because of cannabis.
That's right.
That is a negative side effect of cannabis. And many, many, many of those people are in prison today. Okay? There is a threat of jail, you're right. And there's the reality of jail.
Free Eddie left.
Okay? Free Eddie left. And free all the rest of them, too. Okay? We got a motto of the human solution. No one should go to jail for a plant. And I believe that very strongly. That's one of the reasons I can find everyone. Now, collective operators, there's a lot of them here or people that are participating in the collective in some way or another. Judge Gray said a lot of cops don't know what to do. They don't want to enforce these laws. But there's policy in place. There's policy in place in San Diego County and Los Angeles County in particular, San Bernardino as well, and probably many, many others that I'm not so familiar with. And I've learned this the hard way. Okay, the policy that's in place goes back to this white paper and the California Narcotics Association. And you know how I know this? I've sat in trial for the last 8 days.
Yeah.
I've been raided and I've been investigated and I've watched what they do. I've watched it over and over again in my court hearing and in many others that we support. Now listen to the testimony again and again and again of their experts trained by their people. Now here are some dirty little secrets that a lot of people don't realize. Many collective operators believe that they're in compliance with something. They believe that they're operating under the protection of California 215 and SB 420 and all of its provisions. Okay, that may be so, but let me tell you who doesn't believe that. Okay, that's the Los Angeles District Attorney and the San Diego District Attorney and all of the, and a lot of the judges. Okay, and the willingness of these people to put somebody behind bars that's willing to stand up to them is phenomenal. Most cases, and I'm sure Judge Gray will agree with me, are played out. Very few people take these cases to trial. Okay, I've watched it over and over again. I've talked to attorney after attorney, and I've seen people that have come for support, and then they go away, and I wonder what happened to them. And I find out later, well, they took a no jail deal. And they don't have is the rule. Okay, so I was in a unique position. And I'll give it to you really briefly because it's a long, drawn-out story. In 2008, I was arrested for transportation of cannabis. And after a year-long battle, my case was dismissed. This was in Riverside County, one of the most difficult places at the time. Pacheco was the district attorney, and he was going after everybody. My case was dismissed. I was found to be in compliance with California law. My property was returned. 5 weeks later, I was raided. Okay? Now, this is Long Beach PD. Applies to probably a lot of people here. Okay? They used 120 cops. They raided 15 locations all at once. They arrested lots of people. They went through everything. They spent a year investigating this with 50 officers. We've been to court now. Oh, they offered me a no jail bill. I said, no, thank you. So we go to trial. Prior to trial, the prosecution files a motion to deny my medical defense. The judge granted it. Okay? Picture this, if you will, a compliant, or believing so, medical cannabis collective denying a medical defense. What other defense do you have? You have no other defense. So we took it to the second district and won. You can't take this away from us as easily anymore. Okay? But as soon as the judge found out about that, he got pissed. And we've been in trial. I'm in day 8 today, sitting at the defendant's table. Unable to say a word, so I'm glad you guys are letting me talk right now, because it's pretty tough to be up and out to speak. Now, one of the biggest reasons I want to bring this to your attention is because it affects every single one of you who in some way or another participate in a collective. And I would encourage any of you to go in and take a moment and sit inside this case to see what can happen. Sit inside anytime you hear of a cannabis patient that's in court. Go and sit with them. Number one, it provides support. It shows us as a unified community. We've got a few people here. There's thousands of us. And where are they? I don't know, but we need to start paying attention to that. Start tapping your friend on the shoulder and say, hey, let's go. We need to show up. We need to show up for whatever it is. If it's an initiative, if it's a court case. Prohibition began to end when juries refused to convict. And that's what's happening. And we all understand in the courtroom. That's where these laws are interpreted and enforced. And if the jury won't convict, we don't have this law, and we can end it. So we need to show up. Department K, Long Beach Superior Court, 415 Ocean Boulevard, 2 blocks that way.
K for kangaroo.
K for kangaroo. Absolutely. Absolutely. We have Chris Blue and Allison Margo and our Picture this, most murder trials take less than 3 days. I'm in day